Welcome to the first of two videos on the Voluntary Quality Indicators for Residential Aged Care Facilities, a national program that allows you to measure and benchmark your performance against the sector. This first video will showcase the Quality Indicator application on the My Aged Care Provider portal. The Quality Indicator application allows users to set quality indicator targets for facilities and enter quarterly quality indicator data. The second video showcases how a user is able to access, view, and download their facility reports and data. In this video, we will step through the process of assigning the quality indicator tile, set targets for each of the quality indicators, and enter quality indicator data for the quarter. To initially access the quality indicator application, a user needs to enable the quality indicator tile on their My Aged Care Provider Portal homepage. A user must be an administrator to be able to enter and submit quality indicator data. Users with team leader and staff member roles are able to view submitted data, but cannot enter or submit data. To assign the quality indicator role, you need to click on the yellow staff administration tile. If you do not have access to the staff administration tile, please contact your organizational administrator who can assign the quality indicator to you. In staff administration, choose the user that requires the quality indicator tile by clicking on the user's name. In this example, we will choose our own profile. Click on Edit Staff Details and scroll down to Participating 4 at the bottom of the page and click on the box next to Quality Indicators and then click Save. Each user who is set up with the QI tile will need to log out and log back into the provider portal for the QI tile to show up on their home screen. Once you have logged back into the provider portal, to access the quality indicator application, you need to click on the green quality indicator tile in the bottom right corner of your screen. The quality indicator application has a number of steps to guide you in completing your data submission. The first page you'll see is where you need to select the aged care facility for which you will be submitting quality indicator data for. By clicking the Select Facility button, you will be presented with a list of facilities associated with your organisation. This will be different depending on your role. In this example, the organisation has a number of facilities, each with a different progress indicator for the status of their quality indicator data submission for the current quarter. The four different progress indicators are: Open, indicates that the facility has not yet started their data submission. In Progress, indicates that there is data saved for the facility but has not yet been submitted. Submitted, the facility's data submission for the quarter is complete and has been submitted. Not Started, indicates that the facility data submission has not yet been opened for this quarter. Let's choose the facility with a Not Started progress indicator. Once a facility has been chosen, their name will appear on the screen. Only one facility can be chosen at any one time. You can change your facility selection by clicking on the Set Facility button and choosing another facility. The QI submission status shows the current progress indicator for the selected facility. When you select a facility that has a Not Started progress indicator, this will change to Open. The reporting period end date shows the last date of the current quarter. The reporting period due date shows the date when the quality indicator data must be submitted. Once we have made the facility selection, you press the Continue button to proceed to the next screen. An optional step the facilities may choose is to set targets for each of the quality indicators. Targets are facility-specific optional indicators that will only be reported to the facility. The target indicates the level the facility is aiming for individual quality indicators. Targets set by a facility are not checked or used by the department. Information about establishing targets is included in the QI resource manual at Appendix 9. When you click the triangle next to Set Up Target, the target page will expand and you will be able to enter a target level for each of the quality indicators. Once the targets are set, these will be carried forward to future quarters. The targets can be modified for the current and future quarters, but not for previous quarters. For this example, We will set each target at 2. Once you've entered a target level for each quality indicator, you need to click Save Target. To obtain the most value from the QI program, facilities may wish to collect and submit data on all quality indicators. However, there may be circumstances when this is not always possible. Therefore, the system has been built to allow facilities to decide which of the quality indicators the facility will be submitting for each quarter. You will need to choose either yes or no for each of the quality indicators before you are able to submit any data. When you click yes for submission of data for any quality indicator, the associated data entry form will be displayed. In this instance, we have chosen to submit data for pressure injuries. When a decision to submit data for a quality indicator has been made, each of the questions for that quality indicator is mandatory and must be completed before the form can be submitted. The form can be saved as draft with incomplete information. The first question for pressure injuries is about the number of residents of the aged care facility who were assessed during the quarter for pressure injuries. The second question requires data to be entered via the date picker of when the survey was undertaken. The individual indicators for pressure injuries are then entered with the total number of pressure injuries for the quarter calculated automatically. Once all the data has been entered for a quality indicator, a green tick will appear next to the quality indicator, showing that all the mandatory fields have been completed. If you enter a number that is very high, the quality indicator application may display a warning message. You should check your data to make sure you didn't mistype the number. If it is correct, then this message can be ignored. Any comments that a facility would like to add regarding pressure injuries can be included in the comments field. The comments are only viewable by the department and the facility. Once you've entered all the quality indicator data for the quarter, you can select Clear Form, Save All as Draft, Cancel, or Submit. When you click Clear Form, all the data you entered for the quarter will be removed. Clicking Save All as Draft or Cancel will take you back to the setup page where you can select another facility. Once the quality indicator data has been submitted, facilities are unable to change the data. To amend the data, the facility will need to contact the My Aged Care Provider and Assessor Helpline on 1800 836 799. Once you are happy with the data that you are going to submit for the quarter, you need to click the Submit button. You are then presented with terms and conditions for the submission of the data. Facilities must read the terms and conditions and click either yes or no. If you click no, you'll be sent back to the previous data entry screen. After clicking yes, the data will be submitted and the system will return you to the setup page. At this point, you can enter data for additional facilities within your organization if required. You can also click continue on the facility that you have submitted the quality indicator data for and view the data you've submitted. This concludes the steps involved in submitting your organization's quality indicator data through the My Aged Care Provider portal. Video 2 will demonstrate how to view and download facility reports and data.